Well, I mean, do you think that here's this incredibly totalitarian and brutal country, the most totalitarian country in the history of the world, perhaps, that people would be outraged at? In fact, the brainwashing is every bit as good, I think, as the controls, and people have no other source of information. A radio in North Korea does not have a dial. It has fixed locations, so you can't choose anything but local information. And I'm struck that when I talk to defectors, they say that, yes, they hate the regime, they would like to see it be toppled, but their family back in Pyongyang or back around the country, they still believe in the leadership. So I think that it's a mistake to think that just because it's incredibly brutal that people necessarily are against it.
Let's take a question from the audience. This is from Megan in our audience. So a question for the panel. I may go to Bill Richardson with this, actually. So ask the question, Megan.
Hi. My question is about North Korea, and I just wanted to know, since you've been there, what is daily life there like, and what do they think about America and Americans?
Okay, well, let me. The first part I'm going to put to Nick about daily life, and then, Bill, I'll come to you about the American perception. Nick, what is daily life like in North Korea?
Well, I mean, a lot of it is, of course, hunt for food, for things like this. And but the thing that really struck me the most, Megan, when I kind of randomly walked into homes, and there was always a bit of a stir, this American, you know, wanting to see a home. But I found on every home that there was this speaker on the wall. And, you know, what is a speaker doing on the wall? This is it wakes you up in the morning with propaganda. It puts you to bed at night. And every home in the country, essentially, has that speaker.
Did you find it soothing or not?
I sure did. And no off switch, most of all, no off switch. And, you know, this is just, people have this hostility toward America just bred into them. The axes that were used in the 1976 axes incident, in which two American soldiers were killed, those axes are in a museum that you go through. The Pueblo, which was seized from the U.S., is right in the Capitol, and you tour it. It's become kind of an anti-American museum, too. And I think people kind of absorb this.